हेलो चिल्ड्रन, कभी ऐसा हुआ है कि घर की सारी जिम्मेदारी आपके ऊपर छोड़ दी जाए, चाहे वो आपके ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स की देखभाल हो, चाहे वो आपके घर में जो पालतू जानवर हैं उनकी देखभाल हो, या चाहे खेत का कोई काम हो, खाना बनाने का काम हो, घर की सफाई का काम हो, तो कभी ऐसा हुआ है कि आपके ऊपर जिम्मेदारी छोड़ के मम्मी पापा कहीं चले गए? अच्छा, हुआ है। ऐसे ही हमारे जो आज का हम लेसन पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, हमारा लेसन नंबर 11, लेफ्ट इन चार्ज, इसमें एक बच्चा है भोला, उसके साथ बिल्कुल यही हुआ कि उसके पेरेंट्स ने ढेर सारे काम उसको बता दिए और वो चले गए मार्केट। फिर भोला ने वो काम कैसे किया, आइए देखते हैं। मैं पहले पढ़ूंगी, अपनी किताबें निकाल लीजिए, पेंसिल्स रेडी कर लीजिए, उसके बाद नेक्स्ट लेसन में हम इसको, नेक्स्ट वीडियो में इसका मतलब समझेंगे। पहले आप लोग कोशिश करेंगे। स्टार्ट करते हैं योर लेसन नंबर 11, लेफ्ट इन चार्ज। माँ एंड बापू had put on their new clothes. They were going to town to sell the vegetables grown in their small field. Bhola was very happy. He was not going with his parents. He was left in charge to take care of Dadi Ma. Dadi Ma, 80 years old, a calf, a kid, a rabbit, ducks, a hen with chickens, chicks, and the small vegetable field. His mother warned him, "Don't forget to feed the cattle and the birds. Keep an eye on the rabbit. It is playing there on the green grass in the vegetable field." His father advised him, "Take care of Dadi Ma. Keep her room warm with charcoal and give her warm milk. Give her medicine on time." Bhola promised, nodding his head. He reminded them to bring some sweets, color pencils, and a drawing book. Their bullock cart was going through the narrow street of the village. The waving hands of parents were still visible. Bhola helped Dadi Ma to lie down on the cot. Lying in a corner of the courtyard, he went to the backyard to bring some coal for the angiti to keep Dadi Ma warm, as she was feeling very cold. He saw the calf making sound moo. "Oh, you want some grass?" Bhola kept down his bag, picked up a bundle of grass and ran to the calf. In the corner of the courtyard, he saw the kid jumping and crying, "Meh, what about me?" He kept down his bundle of grass and ran outside the house to get some fresh green leaves for the kid. Only then he saw the rabbit in the vegetable field. He forgot to collect leaves for the kid and rushed towards the rabbit. With a stick, he pushed the rabbit back to its place. Coming back to the house, he found the hen with its chicks making noise. Coo-coo-coo. He jumped to get some corn in the basket for them. There in the courtyard, an army of duck and ducklings was marching making noise, quack, quack. Bhola kept his basket of corn on the floor. He ran to get some water from the well behind the house and came back with a bucket full of water. He kept the bucket also in the middle of the courtyard for the ducks and, feeling tired, went to the veranda where Dadi Ma was sleeping in the sun. He rolled down on the floor and went to sleep. A loud barking woke up Dadi Ma. She cried, "Oh my God, what have you done, Bhola?" Bhola sprang on his feet, blinking his eyes. He could see the ducks flapping their wings. They had rolled down the corn on the courtyard floor. The hen and her chicks were feeding themselves. Outside the house, the goat was chewing some green leaves of vegetable on the vegetable patch. The rabbit was trying to go towards the well. The calf was running and jumping here and there with some grass in its mouth. Suddenly, he heard the jingling bells of the bullock cart coming near the house. He ran to it and jumped into the bullock cart. Clinging to his mother's lap, he murmured, "Oh, what a lot there was to do in the house, Ma." They all went inside the house with the things. The parents noticed that no one was complaining or making noise. Not even the hen and chicks, ducks and ducklings, kid and the calf. Dadi Ma was sleeping in her cot. Bapu patted Bhola's shoulder. "So our little one left in charge. How was the day?" They all smiled slowly. Bhola was happy to see the things that Ma and Bapu had brought for him. Now it's time for silent reading. एकदम ध्यान लगा के आराम से एक बार इस लेसन को रीड आउट कीजिए. जो भी सपोर्टिव टीचर कक्षा में बने हुए हैं वो ज़रा ऐसे बच्चों को देखें जो बच्चे इंग्लिश नहीं पढ़ पाते या उनको किसी प्रकार की डिफ़िकल्टी होती है. प्लीज़ उनको हेल्प करें. सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.